went to medical school with the idea that I would provide medical care to underserved communities. I just thought that that would be a part of what I did.
To me, it's about knowing what other people are dealing with in order to understand how to better help them.
One of my feelings has always been that healthcare is a human right, and unfortunately in this country, it's not true.
Community-based medicine is much more than just, you know, the basic science. It's understanding that patients come from a variety of different backgrounds and that every person comes with their own story.
I grew up in Los Angeles, California, in South Central, where there's not a lot of role models. There's crime everywhere, and it's difficult to navigate through an environment like that, and it's difficult to get proper access to healthcare. And I feel that because I came from that environment, I understand that need.
I was first exposed to medicine as a really little kid. So I was born with a heart murmur, a congenital heart defect. So I had to see pediatric cardiologists all growing up. I had to go to the doctor all the time. And I loved going to the doctor. So most kids, like, they pretty much hate going to the doctor. You have to drag them kicking and screaming. But my cardiologist wanted to see my grades. He wanted to make sure that I was exercising. He wanted to make sure that I was eating well. So that was kind of my first exposure to medicine. And I realized there's a certain level of compassion and there's a certain level of care that can be achieved.
The Arbor Free Clinic is one of the cardinal free clinics of the student-run clinics here at Stanford, whose mission is to serve patients who don't have any other alternative means for health care and to serve as a learning environment for the Stanford medical students.
We typically have first and second year students come into clinic as preclinical students, and especially during your first year you have really no experience in how to interview a patient, how to perform a physical. You're barely learning those skills, and when they come into Arbor they get to practice that.
I'm a first year medical student. I don't know, you know, everything yet. I only know a little bit. And so the first time was pretty funny. But I think the patients are pretty understanding. The nice thing about Arbor is that it is not a hierarchy at all. And a lot of people have this preconception that medicine is very much, you know, you have your attending physician at the top and your residents and your medical students at the bottom. But, you know, the thing about Arbor is everyone's a volunteer. And so the physicians that come here because they like to teach students. To have someone really guide you and not have to be afraid that, you know, you're doing something wrong, that's just really nice.
Most medical school curricula is focused in the classroom. There's a wide body of knowledge that medical students have to acquire in the first 2 years to start to get comfortable with the pathophysiology of the different medical problems that people will come into their clinic with. But they can't get the hands-on experience of seeing the actual burden of disease in an individual patient without interacting with that patient.
Just seeing the cases that we see regularly at clinic, you learn a lot about respiratory infections or abdominal pain or what are the causes. You get to correlate that with what you learn in lecture and through our textbooks.
One of the biggest challenges I think that the students face is when they come here, they'll say, oh, this person needs this and that and this. And then they realize that they can't get all that. They can't get everything that they themselves would get if they went to the doctor.
I think a lot of medical students come in, understandably so, with sort of a God complex of wanting to fix everything, of wanting to change the world. And that's certainly what I want to do, and I think what all my classmates would love to do. But I think Arbor shows that there's a limitation, and there's only so much we can do. And hopefully by kind of gathering all these experiences, you can implement something at a higher level and sort of advocate for all of these patients at a policy level or whether it be a community level.
Everybody is in need of healthcare, and we're trying to provide that and we're trying to fit that need, but yet we're still lacking. Like today, had to tell some people that we couldn't serve them today.
We all need to be activists in healthcare, and if we weren't, we would just go along and take care of our individual patients and not deal really with the big picture that is often a big problem in healthcare, is systems changes. And unless you're involved in the trenches and see that early on, then you may not see some of the solutions.
These are patients who slip through gaps in our current healthcare system, and really are only caught by some form of a safety net. So what this clinic does is it gives the students an opportunity to be a part of the safety net for filling those gaps.
It's just been a great experience for me to be involved with over the years, seeing the energetic students, seeing them make a difference in so many patients' lives.
For some of these people, you know, you may be their, you know, the one person who really cares about them, or the one person who can actually help them.
We are playing a role in their lives, a significant role in their lives, and I think that is what is so rewarding to me, is seeing it played out and seeing them then come back to us and tell us how we have played a role in their lives. And, I mean, that's just beautiful.
The preceding program is copyrighted by the Board of Trustees of the Leland Stanford Junior University. Please visit us at med.stanford.edu.